What is this?
Doom Eternal, the Ancient Gods, the 5 best and 5 worst things about the new DLC. This is going to be fantastic, isn't it? This is going to be a complete ride.
Otra vez, moto. Pinches motos!
So I'm going to speedrun through the 5 best things about the game, because they are really good things that this guy has pointed out. 10. Best new runes. Support runes are absolutely fantastic and they are okay in this DLC. Number 8. Best beautiful maps. The maps in this Ancient Gods DLC, UAC Atlantica, Blood Swamps and the Holt, they are beautiful landscapes of art. The environments in this DLC are complete art. The Holt and Blood Swamps, they look absolutely fantastic, and UAC Atlantica looks like Kamino from Star Wars. It is beautiful art. Number 6. Best new music. Andrew Holschult and David Levy, they deserve all the praise in the goddamn world. They created one of the best soundtracks I've ever heard in the history of gaming. Up there with soundtracks from Mario Donald and Michael Salvatore and Mick Gordon with Doom. It is absolutely great and I loved it. Number 4. Best meaningful plot. In comparison to other games journalists, this guy enjoys the plot of Doom Eternal and agrees with what the game is setting up for. The match against the Dark Lord, how we're going to save the Earth, our match against Hell, and everything else. And number 2. Best anticipation of the Ancient Gods Part 2. The Ancient Gods Part 2 is going to be way harder, is going to give us more lore about the game, and the story is going to be a very good storytelling or plot. I don't know how to say it. Those were the 5 best things about the Ancient Gods Part 1 according to Game Rant. Now let's go to the 5 worst things about the Ancient Gods Part 1. But before we begin, if you enjoy Doom and want to know everything about the franchise, click subscribe. It is absolutely free. Click the bell to get all future videos. As it is also free, please leave a huge like right now. Leave a like, subscribe and click the bell immediately at this very moment. Thanks for the support and enjoy the video, my friends. Now, I didn't want to do this video because I've done like this same video 6 times ever since Doom Eternal came out, but whenever there's a dumb article about the game or any game like Demon's Souls as well, you guys always flood my Twitter DMs, Instagram and Discord with, oh my god, Midnight, react to this article by WatchMojo, by Kotaku, by GameRant, or by whoever the hell is talking about this game, I don't know. So, if you guys want me to do it, I am going to deliver, because apparently you guys enjoy this type of content, which is, I don't know, I find it weird, but if you enjoy it, then I am going to deliver. So, number 1. Worst, assumes ported game. The Ancient Gods Part 1 can be attempted without completing the campaign. It should not be. What? Why? That's a good thing. That's a good thing, man. This is about way more than spoilers. If the player has printed the game on another console or deleted the old save file, the game will likely need to be completed again. Why? That doesn't make any sense whatsoever. Why would you need to beat the game, the best campaign, again if the file was deleted? It's a standalone DLC. That does not need to be done. Players that attempt to beat the game without first getting through the campaign will feel like they are using every last drop of skill on Nightmare Mode, even when the game is on the easiest setting. The first encounters are a smash in the teeth, I agree with that completely, and without the weapon and armor upgrades, it will be nearly impossible to get through 3 full instances. Okay, by my understanding, GameRant thinks that if you haven't beaten the base campaign of Doom Eternal, if you begin the Ancient Gods Part 1, you are not going to get all your armor upgrades and your weapon upgrades. And that is nonsensical, because its software has said multiple goddamn times in interviews, deals, trailers, Reddit posts and whatever, that the Ancient Gods Part 1 is a standalone DLC. You do not need to own the base campaign or the base game of Doom Eternal to play this DLC, as it is standalone. So, if that was the case, if you needed to beat the base campaign to play this DLC, then that would be unfair for new players that haven't tried the base campaign, but they want to try the game with the DLC, because they would not be able to access all the armor upgrades, runes, sentinel crystals, sentinel armor points, and all the weapon upgrades. And that would be really unfair, because Ancient Gods Part 1 throws everything at you, basically, because you are an armed up slayer. So this guy, GameRant, didn't play or didn't even pay attention to that, because that is a straight lie. That is a lie. This guy is lying. That is a taste of a liar. Number 2, worst platforming. Here we go again. Gamers on a mission to find Doom Eternal's most hidden details are going to have to pull off a series of absurd platform jumps and drops. Nothing changes in the Ancient Gods Part 1, complete with all of that clunky meter maneuvering. Okay, there's no clunky meter maneuvering. There is a rune named Air Control that specifically mentions and lets you control your slayer, your character, way better in the air. If you are not playing the game with that rune on, you are missing a whole layer of gameplay in the game, for sure. And also, Easter eggs and all the hidden details like codexes, extra BFG cells, soul spheres, and all the secrets should be hard to access. Don't you remember back in OG Doom 1 and Doom 2, all the secrets were a pain to access because, one, you needed to platform in the game, or they were plain on hidden from the player's sight, and you will only be able to find them if you like pressed use through every goddamn wall in the game to see if something activates or I don't know. That's bad game design. The way you put it, that's bad game design. Hidden Easter eggs, hidden secrets should be hard to get in every single game, because they are a reward, because you are trying to explore more parts of the game. Explore the sandbox. Motos! This is a perplexing, because the feedback about the platforming in the original game was widely criticized, so doubling down on it in the DLC is a head-scratcher. That's not to say all platforming is bad, okay, but the mechanics need to be drastically upgraded before giving players any more trust falls. The platforming in this game is not even hard, you just need to jump, and that's it. If you do not have air mobility on, then you're going to have a hard time trying to maneuver in the air, but still, it's just a straight line. Imagine if you try to do the Pro-T parkour mid-hook mod he's doing. That's going to be hard if you do not know how to press A or space, or whichever button you have binded to jump in your PC. Number 5, or number 3, worst. Precise hit locations. Do not conflate this criticism with the presence of new enemies. The work by the team to manufacture extra enemies is appreciated. Of course, more content, more enemies to destroy, that's a good thing. But two of the new demons introduced have a very precise hit point that basically needs to be sniped. Oh, I am sorry, you need to snipe and be precise with your shots. I am sorry, I'm not giving you everything on a silver platter for you to be able to kill this demon. Aside from one's weapon's alternate fire, which can hardly be described as a sniper rifle, he's referring to the heavy cannon, there is no way to deal with these targets well. Buckle up, Doom Eternal fans, the most horrifying enemies in the game just got even more horrific. He's talking about the Blood Angels, and of course the Maker Drones, and probably about the weak points, but mainly about the Blood Angels. Oh, my voice just cracked. The Blood Angels, yes, they're a complete pain in the ass, because they are invulnerable to any attacks while they are being passive. When they try to do their big attacks, they are going to get off of that invulnerability state, and you can either A, damage damage them and glory kill them, or B, snipe them in the head with the ballista, the heavy cannon, or with a grenade launcher. If you do that, they are going to explode and give you a reward, which is armor, health, and a lot of ammo. So sniping that blood angel gives you a reward, but you can still just completely melt him with a lock-on rocket launcher and all that stuff. This is a straight lie. You do not have to snipe them specifically. You can kill them just by shooting. Stay in the air, throw an ice grenade and just completely melt them. Yes, they need to be dealt with really quick, because if you let them live, they are going to stagger you, stop you in your tracks and kill you, and let everyone in the arena to completely murder you with their claws. I apologize that you need to aim with your mouse or your joystick to kill the demon. I mean, I apologize for that. That hasn't been done in every single game in the world. It's like saying like, oh, I hate Halo 3 because when I grab the sniper rifle, I need to snipe them in the head if I want to kill them instantly. Oh my god. Why am I being such an ass? I apologize. Sometimes I am very rude and I apologize for that. I cannot get over my head just how much they want the developers to give them in a silver plate to every single player. Like, they want the game to be easy as hell, and that's not a game. You want to, if you want a walking simulator, go play another game. I don't know. Number four, worst, even a higher difficulty. What? The game is more harder? No. If the game is harder, I'm going to dislike this DLC even more. Thought Ultra Nightmare was a tough task in Doom Eternal? That was nothing, even with full upgrades from the campaign. Pro players that are attempting the Ancient Gods Part 1 are reaching triple digit death counts before finishing map number 1. Okay, triple digit death counts. I mean, you died 100 times in map number 1. If that's the case, man, you need to lower the difficulty. If you are dying on nightmare difficulty or ultra violence, lower it to I'm too junk to die or hurt me plenty. There's no shame in doing that. If you are dying a lot, lower the difficulty. I myself, I never lower the difficulty in my personal experience because I like challenges. I like getting frustrated at not being able to kill that marauder in the blood swamps, or not being able to kill the assholes of the pain elemental and the dread knight buffed demons at the very end of the DLC campaign. Okay, I get frustrated, but instead of lowering the difficulty to ultra violence, I stay on nightmare because I like when I like the power fantasy of feeling good because I beat the challenge. I like that. But if you don't, man, lower the difficulty. And come on, man, don't lie. No one is dying 100 times on map number 1. And if they do, they need to lower the difficulty because that difficulty is not for them. Just do it. There's no shame on doing that. And okay, number 5 or number 1, depending on how I'm counting it on the article. Worst, bridges burned. Big spoilers are coming up here in this last section, so if you haven't played Ancient Gods Part 1, do not watch this. It is a heartbreaking doozy, especially for gamers that have been following along since Doom 2016. Vega, Aiden, and the Slayer have had a contentious friendship for the entire series, but the disagreements finally got the best of them in a final showdown. Dialogue indicates that Aiden and the father may or may not be at war with the Slayer, but at the very least, their alliance with the Doom guy appears to have ended tragically. Okay, so yes, the Doom Slayer almost killed Samuel Aiden, aka the Seraphim, and Vega is not on war with Slayer. He's the father, he's the supreme being, but he's just a medium right now. He can't do anything. He's not complaining about where the story's going. He just feels like, damn it, Vega and Aiden, enemies now? That sucks. And yes, when I was playing the campaign, when I reached the ending by almost killing the Seraphim, I was like, no, I don't want to kill Sammy. Please, Samuel Aiden, please, Slayer, don't kill Sammy. I don't want him to die. He has done really shady stuff in the past. He did save the Earth countless times. He did make the Ark to make the last resistance against the demons, and he did try to save the humans and help them. But still, he is in the way of the Slayer. The Slayer wants that there are no gods in the universe. He wants the best for humanity, and if the best for humanity is goddamn killing the highest angel in heaven and killing the father or god as well, then he might as well do it, because the father, even though he's a supreme being, is not a good person. He didn't destroy hell when he had the chance, basically. But yes, this was one of the worst reviews I've seen about Doom Eternal Ancient Gods since it was released almost a month ago. This is the 17th of November, so almost a month ago. I mean, this person, or he lied to push his narrative of Ancient Gods Part 1 being super hard, and oh my god, you do not have all your weapon upgrades and armor, so you need to play the best campaign first, and oh my god. Or he didn't play the game outright, so yes. I don't know how to end this video, so yes, guys, thanks for coming, thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you in my next video. Adios, bye.